One of the things that my friends kind of laugh at me about is that when someone asks me what I do for a living, I don't say I own a multi-million dollar corporation. I don't say I'm an author. I don't say, you know, I'm a master coach instructor. I don't say anything. I say I'm a life coach, because that is what I am first and foremost.
Being a life coach is to me the honor of my lifetime. To be able to work with people on making their life the best version that they can possibly live is truly an honor. I can't even explain it. I love doing that more than I love doing anything else on the planet.
Today, we are going to be coaching. We're going to be talking about your individual struggle, your individual issue, your individual desire for help, need for help in making the decision of whether you should become a life coach, whether you should sign up for certification.
When I first started off as a life coach, it was a brand new industry and a lot of people were calling themselves life coaches. They were talking about being life coaches, but they hadn't gone through the training that I had done. They hadn't been taken as seriously. They weren't bound by the ethics. And so a lot of people started seeing life coaches as just hobbyists, as just people that were kind of playing around, because we have an industry that's unregulated. And so a lot of people kept saying to me, I don't want to be called a life coach. You shouldn't call yourself a life coach, because it wasn't seen as a very respectable profession at the time. And a lot of people didn't even know what it was. And so what I decided was I was going to own that term and change it if I needed to. I was going to create the respect around it that I wanted to do. And one of the reasons why I really wanted to do that for life coaching is because I did feel like being a therapist or saying I was a psychotherapist would have commanded more sophisticated respect in my mind. I kind of had this imagery of that. But yet I had studied psychotherapy, and psychotherapy is all about solving a problem. It's all about, hey, something's non-functioning in your life, come to therapy and let's solve it. And I wanted to be part of something that wasn't necessarily solving a problem, but was creating greatness. And those are two very different approaches. Now, of course, we solve problems in life coaching, and that is one of the main things that we do, but that's not the philosophy behind it. The philosophy behind it is living your very best life, not just getting you back to normal, but living at the highest level that you could possibly live. And that's what really excited me about being a life coach and owning that term. And that was, you know, what, 18 years ago now. And I have committed to owning that term, calling it the life coach school, calling myself a life coach. And even today, when someone asks me what I do for a living, I say a life coach. I'm a very good coach because I've coached for thousands of hours, but I also am committed to teaching. And I'm also committed to marketing. So I have like this trifecta of skills that makes me the perfect person to run the life coach school, because I can teach you how to be a life coach. I can demonstrate by coaching you, and I can also teach you how to market your business and become the most successful, wealthy version that you want to become. I don't think there is any more important skill than being able to manage your mind at the level that I manage my mind at, and to be able to help the people that you're supporting or who are working for you to be able to do the same. So I want to first and foremost invite you into this industry with the utmost pride of what it means to be a life coach. And if someone doesn't understand the magnificence that that is, it's our job to educate them. It's our job to show them. I feel like in many ways, the way I live my life as a life coach changes the perception of what it means to be one. And I think that should be true for all of us in our lives. Thinking about the model and thinking about what we teach in certification, we can really solve any problem utilizing the construct of the model. If you are a life coach, in order to use my model with your clients, you have to be certified through me in order to be licensed to use it. It's one thing to be in Scholars. It's one thing to be in one of my students' courses and to learn it as a student, as a client. But in order to coach people on it, my opinion is you have to learn how to hold space at a mastery level. What I'm offering is all the training to master at that level. So someone was asking about the training. So just let me briefly explain. The first 6 months of the training is a class every single week taught by me on video. So you watch the video, and then immediately after that, you go into a practicum with 10 people and a coach instructor that's been approved by me that you work with in that group every single week. And what you'll realize is when you first start that, you'll be like, I know the model, I understand this, I've been coached, and then you'll realize how little you know when you start coaching in a group of people. Think about this, everybody think about this with me together. If you sign up for life coach training and you tell yourself, I will pay myself back within the first year, come hell or high water, no matter what, I will pay myself back. And you believe that no matter what comes your way, no matter what you struggle with, no matter how many times you fail, you believe that with all of your heart. Not only will you become a life coach, not only will you be certified, not only will you have an entirely new set of skills, but you will have overcome one of the blocks, the money blocks of belief systems that tells us that money comes from outside of us instead of from within us, right? I had this same doubt when I hired my coach. But are you willing to go all in and bet on yourself? I don't think there's any more important work to do in your life than believing in yourself. And there's something that happens in your relationship with yourself when you're willing to bet on yourself. And so that's what you have to negotiate with yourself. And I always tell, don't sign up until you believe in yourself. And we will help you to continue to believe in yourself through the training, but you have to have at least that initial, let's go. I want to try this. As soon as you sign up, I know some of you on this call have already signed up. You're going to freak out. That's normal. It's your brain freaking out. It's what you do with the freak out that matters, right? It's how you manage that that matters. Listen, I was totally freaked out, but I keep committing to believing in myself. So it's not even just the training that offers you the transformation. It's the nerve to sign up for it and to kick ass at it and to build a business from it. If you want to find out more, go to thelifecoachschool.com/certification. It would be my honor to have you join us. If you join now, you get instant access to scholars for free until class starts. It's a huge bonus. I highly recommend if you do that, you jump in, you start learning the material, you start getting coached, you start practicing the skills that you're going to be mastering in certification. Again, it would be my honor to be your teacher. Please come and join us at certification at the Life Coach School.